everyone. Let me just say thank you to the Labor Heritage Foundation for giving me the opportunity to say a few words about Ken Rigney. Ken is a leader's leader. And when I say that, many of you may be thinking of folks with fancy titles and political positions and whatnot. And yes, he does lead in those circles. But what I really mean is that Ken recognizes, acknowledges, and celebrates what every worker brings to our movement. So if you're a politician, a union leader, an apprentice, or the waiter serving the table, Ken is even-handed and balanced. He invites the creativity, the initiative of every single person that crosses his path. He creates welcoming spaces, and he nourishes ideas. And with Ken Rigney, nobody is invisible. And you guys are scaring me, you're really quiet. So I had the distinct honor and pleasure to be in the year-long leadership program with Ken. And we were asked to define and challenge, discover, imagine, and reinvent leadership styles and leadership structures. And while I kind of struggled through, Ken was a natural. He was supportive of all of those around him. He was a visionary with working class clarity on the difficult questions of power, entitlement, bias, mission, and vision. He modeled and models for us all self-criticism, teaches us how to conduct honest critique of our work. He's unafraid of weakness. He's determined to problem solve. And he provides an analysis that gets to the essence, never getting distracted by the noise, the irrelevant, or the nonsense. And always, and I mean always, with an abundance of respect, whether you agree with him or not. So, I think those of us in this room have experienced Ken's leadership in so many settings. You know, he knows the issues. Pensions and training and healthcare and contracts and organizing and civil and human rights, and the list goes on and on, but I think you get my point. He has proven over and over his expertise and his skill. And the International Union of Painters and Allied Trades is evidence of a union leader with no bounds for excellence. Ken is a movement leader who not only understands the barriers to a more equitable world, he does not blur the lines between income inequality, racial and gender inequality. For him, for Ken, every day he wakes up to address those complex economic, political, social, and cultural issues that is so much more than just acknowledging and removing barriers. For Ken, it's building a world that all workers deserve. And sisters and brothers, that is courage. That is courage. So if Ken were here tonight, he would be the first one to acknowledge all of you in this room, his union family. He would rightfully credit each and every one of you for the work you do, for getting up every day and moving the ball forward to a better world. He would thank you for being teachers and for being learners and for leaning in the struggle to create a better world. To my friend and to your friend, Kay Grigming, we're grateful. We're grateful to have you in the American labor movement, in the worldwide movement for workers. Sisters and brothers, from the bottom of my heart, I want to say to my brother Ken Rigmaiden, mil gracias, hermano.